हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन 15th वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ यूनिट 2 दैट इज स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ एटम यू विल बी स्टडी टुवर्ड्स पाउलीज एक्सक्लूजन प्रिंसिपल एंड सम क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन क्वांटम नंबर्स। पाउलीज एक्सक्लूजन प्रिंसिपल कैन बी डिफाइंड एज इट इज इम्पॉसिबल टू कंसिस्ट सेट ऑफ 4 क्वांटम नंबर फॉर एनी 2 इलेक्ट्रॉन विथ आइडेंटिकल वैल्यू। It can be also defined as no 2 electrons in an atom can have the same set of all the 4 quantum numbers, that is N, L, M and S. Each electron in an atom is fully characterized by a set of 4 quantum number. In 1925, Pauliz presented a principle which controls the assignment of values to quantum numbers of an electron in an orbital. For the definition of Pauli's exclusion principle, we may define this one in other words. An orbital cannot have more than 2 electrons because these quantum numbers, that is principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number and magnetic quantum number, at the most may be same, but the fourth must be different. Fourth must be different means spin quantum number must be different. It means that if principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number and magnetic quantum number for any 2 electron if having identical value, then fourth quantum number, that is spin quantum number, is found to be with the different value. Here for the first, in the case of n is equal to 2, that is second cell, we may take L value, M value and S value. So here n is equal to 2 means principal quantum number value is 2, means second cell is given. So for this one, L value will be 0 and 1. So in the current example, and L value 1 with respect to 1 is given. So L is equal to 1. So L is equal to 1. So here M value taken as 0. So S value may be here plus half. It is for first electron. And if we take the second electron for second cell, for L value is equal to 1, M value is 0, but S value is minus half. So here three things means principal quantum number, azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number. First and second electron are same, but fourth quantum number, that is spin quantum number, consists the different value. For first electron it is plus half and for second electron minus half. This principle can be illustrated by taking another example also. Here for nitrogen, N7 means nitrogen containing atomic number 7. If we write the electronic configuration, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. Student, you will be to write the electronic configuration in term of subshell in next video lecture. So here nitrogen containing atomic number 7, so its electronic configuration in term of subshell 1s2, 2s2, 2p3. So here 1s2, 2s2, p subshell, as you already know that p subshell consists 3 orbital, px, py, pz. And if we fill the electron, so as we know that each orbital can hold the maximum 2 electron. But during the filling the electron, first of all we fill 1 electron in each, and then if the electron is remain left, then we fill the second electron in each orbital with the opposite spin. This is known as Hund's rule. This will be known afterward. So here for 2p3, 3 electron, in px 1 electron, therefore 2px1, in py 1 electron, therefore it is 2py1, and in pz 1 electron, that is 2pz1. So principal quantum number 1s2. So here principal quantum number will be first, 2s2 principal quantum number will be 2, and here 2p also principal quantum number will be 2, azimuthal quantum number for n is equal to 1. You know that L value is found to be 0 to n minus 1. So for n is equal to 1, L value will be 0 to n minus 1, means 0 to 1 minus 1, that is 0 to 0 means 0. Similarly, for principal quantum number 2, m value here, principal quantum number 2, m value, L value will be 0 to 1. 0 to 1 means for n is equal to 2, L value 0 to n minus 1, to L is equal to 0 to n minus 1, 0 to 2. N value is 2, so 2 minus 1. So 0 to 1, that is 0 and 1. So here, for 0, here it is taken. Add 2p3. Again, the quantum number is second. For that one, first. Here, for second quantum number, L value 0 and 1. So 0 is here and 1 is here. For PS, PY, PZ, all having the L value 1. Now, magnetic quantum number. To find out magnetic quantum number, as we know that magnetic quantum number is m is equal to minus al2 plus l including 0. So, accordingly, if we put the value for magnetic quantum number m, so here for l is equal to 0, m will be also 0. For l is equal to 0, again m will be 0. But here for L is equal to 1, in all the cases 1, 1, 1 given. So here for first one plus 1, for second one minus 1, for third one 0. We may write this one as also minus 1, 0, plus 1. Spin of electron. If we take the spin of electron, so here 1s2. In the case of first subshell, first cell 1s2, 2 electron is here. Therefore, it will have the value 1 for plus and next for second for minus. Similarly, in the case of 2s2, first electron plus half, second electron minus half. In the case of 2p3, 3 electron there, px1, py1, pz1. So here all the 3 electron in 2p3 having the parallel spin, means each orbital containing one electron and it is in upward direction. Therefore, all these three electrons px1, py1, pz1 will have spin plus half each. Out of 7 electrons, no 2 have same value of all 4 quantum numbers. So total number of electrons are 7. 1 electrons are 7. So here electron first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, 7. If we compare the value of all the set of 4 quantum numbers, that is N, L, M, and S, then no one have the identical value with this identical value. So here, with the help of this principle, it is possible to calculate the maximum number of electrons which can be accommodated in main energy shell and subshells. In this table, Pauli exclusion principle is implement. Here, principal quantum number value is taken as 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever. Accordingly, we may take the azimuthal quantum number L, magnetic quantum number M, and also spin quantum number S. And number of electron finally we may take in the case of each principal quantum number, and we may also find out the number of electron on a subshell. So here, for the first principal quantum number, means for the first cell, that is for the L cell, for the K cell, principal quantum number 1, that n is equal to 1 here. So for this one, if you write L value, so L value we already know 0 to n minus 1. So n value is 1, so 0 to n minus 1 means 0 to 1 minus 1, that is 0. So here L value will be 0. Similarly, if you find out M value, so M, we know that value of M depend upon value of L, azimuthal quantum number. So m will, since in this case L value is 0, so m value will be 0 because m is equal to plus minus L to plus L including 0. So here L value is 0, therefore m value is also 0. If we take the spin of electron, as we know that each orbital, here magnetic quantum number indicate towards the orbital, here one orientation of orbital that can accommodate two electron. So for first electron spin will be plus up and for second electron minus up. So total number of electron on a subshell, that is in 1s2, it will be 2 electron. Number of electron on the main shell, that is principal quantum number 1, this will be 2 electron. Similarly for the second principal quantum number, means for the second shell have the L value. As you know that number of L value is equal to number of principal quantum number. So here N value means principal quantum number value second, means 2. So here for the second principal quantum number, L value will be N is equal to 2. So L value we know that 0 to N minus 1. So it will be 0 and 1. For L value 0, magnetic quantum number will be 0. But for L value 1, that is P subshell, the M value will be minus 1, 0, plus 1. And these minus 1, 0, plus 1, these indicating orbital. So total number of orbital 3. Here total number of orbital 3, minus 1, 0, plus 1. And each orbital can accommodate 2 electrons. Therefore, spin quantum number for the magnetic quantum number having its value minus 1 will be plus half, minus half. Similarly, for principal magnetic quantum number value 0, the spin quantum number will be plus half, minus half. And for M value plus 1, the magnetic spin value will be plus half, minus half. And we know the number of electrons. So 2 electrons, if we want to find out number of electrons on a subshell, so your subshell will be 2s2 and 2s and here 2p. S subshell having 2 electrons and P subshell having total 6 electrons. So it will be 2 electrons in S subshell and 6 electrons in P subshell. So at a glance, if we find out the number of electrons in main shell, that is in second shell, then it will be 2 plus 6 is equal to 8 electron. Similarly, we may find out the value of L, M, S for particular shell as well as the number of electron in particular subshell, and we can find out the total number of electron in given principal quantum number. Here for the third shell given, for the fourth shell, if we consider fourth shell means N value is equal to N, principal quantum number N value is equal to 4. So for that, if we write L value, means azimuthal quantum number, so azimuthal quantum number L is equal to what? 0 to N minus 1. So here N value is 4, so 0 to N minus 1 means 0, it will equal to 0 to 4 minus 1, means 0 to 3. So what can we write? We may write this one as 0 to 3 means 0, 1, 2, 3. So L value, that is subshell, will be 0 means 4S, 1 means 4P, 2 means 4D, and 3 means 4F. Here we may also take the value of M. For L value 0, M value will be 0. For L value 1, M value will be minus 1, 0, plus 1. For L value 2, M value will be minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. These are not given here. Total number of electron, here 1s, fourth cell, therefore 4s2, 2 electron. Here 4p, 6, 6 electron. And here 4d, 10, total 10 electron. So here SF cell have 2 electron, P subshell can accommodate 6 electron, and D subshell 10 electron. So if we find out the total number of electron in the fourth cell, that is N value is equal to 4, so here 2 plus 6 plus 10, so 18 electron will be here in the case of SPD. But if we know द वैल्यू ऑफ टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू एफ, हियर इट इज टेकन 3F means L value 3, so it means F orbitals means F subshell. So here we may write this one, L value is 3, so if we want to write this one as with respect to the subshell, so we may write this 3 value of F, so here L, so we may write this one with respect to subshell at 4S, as 4 we may write 4AF, we may write 4AF this one with respect to subshell. So 4 here indicating principal quantum number, F indicating subshell. Subshell means azimuthal quantum number. So corresponding value with respect to corresponding L value, we may summarize the value of magnetic quantum number. So here L value means azimuthal quantum number value is 3. Therefore magnetic quantum number value M, we already know, minus L to plus L. So here minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. So total number of orbital, that is total value of magnetic quantum number is 7. And we know that magnetic quantum number indicate orbital. Each orbital also have the 2 electron. So here with respect to the magnetic quantum number value minus 3, total number of electron will be 2. Spin of first electron will be plus half, for second minus half. Similarly in each orbital 2 electron will be there with opposite spin. One will have the plus half value with respect to spin and next will have the minus. So if we take the total number of electron in these orbitals, then it will be 14. 2 here, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14. So 14 electron is here in the corresponding subshell, means 4F subshell, the total number of electron is 14. So on the these 14 electron are with respect to the 7F orbital, because yes, each orbital has the 2 electron and total 7 orbital, so 14 electron. And total number of electron, if we consider in the case of fourth shell, so we may find the total number of electron also by counting from here. So here total number of electron, if we count, then it is total 32, because here from here we may find here 2 to 4, 6, 10 to 12, 6, 18, 10, 28 to 30. Likewise we may find for the fourth cell, here we counting for fourth cell is here, fourth cell with respect to fourth cell. So with respect to fourth cell will be here, these value from here, total number of electron. So 14 plus 10, 24, 6, 30 up to 32. So in the case of fourth cell, the principal quantum number value 4, 32 electron. In the case of principal quantum number 3, total number of electron will be 18. So for the third cell, means principal quantum number value 3, total number of electron 18. So these are the electron for this one, for principal quantum number third, 2 plus 6, 8, 10, 18. Total number of electron in this cell, 18. Similarly, we may take the total number of electron in second cell. So here second cell is given, which have 2s2, 2p6. The total number of electron will be, for second cell will be 2 plus 6 is equal to 8. And for the first cell, means principal quantum number value 1, first, the total number of electron in the first cell will be 2. So likewise, we may find out the value of azimuthal quantum number, magnetic quantum number, spin quantum number, as well as number of electron on a particular subshell. And by adding the total number of electron subshell related to the particular quantum number, we can calculate the aggregate number of electron for that principal quantum number, means for that shell. Conclusion of Pauli's exclusion principle. So from the conclusion is that द मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी ऑफ मेन एनर्जी सेल इज इक्वल टू 2n स्क्वायर इलेक्ट्रॉन मीन्स इन द पर्टिकुलर मेन एनर्जी मीन्स इन द पर्टिकुलर प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर द टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन मीन्स मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन में बी 2n स्क्वायर. सपोज द n वैल्यू इज 4 एंड यू वांट टू फाइंड n वैल्यू इज 4 मीन्स फोर्थ सेल. यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. सो टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी इक्वल टू 2n स्क्वायर. सो n वैल्यू इज 4 प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम 4 गिवन. सो 2 इंटू स्क्वायर ऑफ 4 सो इट विल बी 2 इंटू 16 इट विल बी 32 मीन्स इन द केस ऑफ फोर्थ सेल 32 मैक्सिमम इलेक्ट्रॉन कैन बी फाउंड विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू 32 इलेक्ट्रॉन. मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इन फोर्थ सेल विल बी 32. सो लाइक वाइज वी मे फाइंड आउट मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इन एनी सेल मीन्स इन एनी प्रिंसिपल क्वांटम नंबर. नाउ सेकेंड पॉइंट कंक्लूजन इज दैट द मैक्सिमम कैपेसिटी ऑफ ए सब सेल इज इक्वल टू 2 × 2L + 1 इलेक्ट्रॉन. मीन्स इफ यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट द टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इन द पर्टिकुलर सब सेल देन इट इज 2 × 2L + 1. सपोज एल वैल्यू इज 2 एल वैल्यू इज 2 एंड यू वॉन्ट टू फाइंड आउट नंबर ऑफ एल वैल्यू इज 2 मीन्स इट इज विच सब सेल डी सब सेल. इट इज विच सब सेल डी. टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इन डी सब सेल 2 × 2L + 1. सो हियर वी मे फाइंड आउट टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन. टोटल इलेक्ट्रॉन विल बी 2 × L, 2 × L value is given 2 + 1. सो हियर 2 × 2 × 2 = 4 + 1 = 5. सो 5 × 2 विल बी इक्वल टू 10 मीन्स इन डी सब सेल टोटल नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इज फाउंड टू बी 10. सो लाइक वाइज वी मे calculate the number of electron corresponding to the particular subshell. That may be S subshell, that may be P subshell, that may be D subshell, that may be F subshell. In this table, these things are calculated. For example, sub-energy label, that is subshell, are given S, P, D and F. Azimuthal quantum number for S subshell 0, for P 1, for D 2 and for F 3. Maximum capacity of electron by implementation of formula 2 × 2L + 1 we may find out. For the S subshell total electron will be equal to 2, for the P subshell 6 electron, for the D subshell 10 electron and for the F subshell 14 electron. Therefore during writing the electronic configuration we write 1s2 means S subshell of first cell can have the 2 electron. For P we write P6 means P subshell have the 6 electron means 3 orbital, each orbital have 2 electron, therefore 6 electron. Likewise in all the cases. Next conclusion is that number of subshell in a main energy cell means principal quantum number, is equal to the value of n. Means always, in other words we may say that always value of n is found to be equal to value of l. Suppose that you want to take n value is equal to 2. Therefore, L value, to find out L value is 0 to n minus 1, 0 to n minus 1. So, here 0 to, n value is given to 0 to 2 minus 1 means 0 to 1. It will equal to 0 to 1 means 0 and 1. So, total value is 0 also having one position and 1. 2 values here and n value is also so. Always value of n means principal quantum number is found to be equal to the value of a subshell, that is azimuthal quantum number. Now from here we may calculate, we may follow the conclusion means the number of n is equal to number of l by this example. So here value of n 1 subshell energy level 1 designation 1s, this you already know. For second cell number of subshell will be 2, that is 0 and 1, so 2 it will be 2s2p. For third cell means principal quantum number value 3, it will be 0. L value means sub energy level, that is L value will be 0 1 2, so total is 3 here. So it is 0 implement S, 1 implement P and 2 implement D. And it corresponds to the third cell, therefore it will be 3s, 3p, 3d. In the case of fourth cell, that is principal contact number value 4, total value of L will be 4, because here n value is 4, so L value is 0 to n minus 1, so it will be 0 to 4 minus 1, so 0 to 3 means 0, 1, 2 and 3, so total value 0, 1, 2 and 3, total value 4, so and it belong to the fourth cell, therefore it is 0 corresponds to the S, 1 corresponds to P subcell, 2 corresponds to D subcell and 3 corresponds to F subcell, therefore the designation will be as 4S, 4P, 4D and 4F. Now next conclusion is that number of orbital in a mean energy cell is equal to n square. If you want to find out number of orbital in the particular principal quantum number, then we have to do square of n. For example, suppose n value is equal to 2, means second cell, and you want to find out number of orbital in main energy, number of orbital, so n square means square of 2, so 2 is square of 2 will be equal to 4. We may find value 4 theoretically also. So here what is given? Main energy level. Main energy level we took 2, and you want to find out total number of orbital. Total number of orbital means magnetic quantum number. So we may solve this one. N value we taken in this example 2. So L value will be, L value how we calculate? 0 to n minus 1. So 0 to 2 minus 1 means 0 and 1 will be L value. But here we going to find out number of orbital. So number of orbital calculated with respect to the magnetic quantum number. So magnetic quantum number M, you already know, minus L to plus L including 0. So for L value 0, magnetic quantum number will be 0. But for L value is equal to 1, magnetic quantum number will be minus 1, 0, plus 1. So total value is here 3 and 1 with respect to L is equal to 0, M is equal to 0. So total value is 4. So theoretically and by the formula n square, we getting the same value. 4 is here also, 4 is here also. So to find out number of total orbital in a particular principal quantum number means particular cell, we have to do the square of n. Now likewise we may find the value, as we already discussed. Fifth point is that one orbital cannot have more than 2 electrons. This you already know. In the particular orbital, 2 electrons. Suppose this is the orbital. So 2 electrons can be accommodated in this one with the opposite spin. So each orbital have only 2 electrons, not more than 2 electrons. So maximum number of electrons in the particular orbital is found to be equal to 2. Minimum may be 0 or 1, but maximum it is found to be 2. So remember this point. Now students, you have to here next point is one orbital cannot have the more than 2 electrons. This we already discussed. If 2 electrons are present, their spin should be opposite in direction. It means if 2 electrons is there in the particular orbital, then one should have the upward spin and one should next should have downward spin, means opposite spin are formed, means paired electron are formed with the opposite spin. Now students, you have to solve some question based on quantum numbers. Like in first question, give the name magnetic quantum number and number of orbitals for each subcell with the following quantum number. So in the first case here, n value is 3, L value is 2. So n value is 3 means third cell, L value is 2 means D subcell. With respect to here we have to find out magnetic quantum number and number of orbitals. So here n value is equal to 3 and L value is equal to 2. So L value is equal to 2 means D subcell. Since D subcell correspond to the third main energy level, therefore it will be 3D. And to find out the subcell value will be L is equal to 2, subcell name will be 3D because it belongs to the third cell. Now possible value of M, class you already know that to find out value of m, we start from the value of l. So l value is here 2, and you know that m is equal to minus l to plus l including 0. So if we implement this trend, then here for l value is equal to 2, we may write minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. So total value, partial value of m will be 5. So here we may implement with respect to the axis also. So it is belong from the d subset. So these are the 5 d orbitals. We may say this one dxy, dyz, dzx, dx square, y square, and dz square. Likewise, we may represent. So total number of orbital is here 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now second question, n value is equal to 2 and l value is equal to 0. So here n value is equal to 2 means second cell, and l value is equal to 0 means S subcell. So with respect to this one, we have to find out name of subcell and possible value of magnetic quantum number. So here in the second case, it is given that in the second case, n value 2 and l value 0. N value 2, L value 0. Number of subcell name. So here L value 0 means S subcell. Since it belongs to the second cell, therefore 2S. Now orbital. You know that number of orbital M. Number of orbital means value of magnetic quantum number m. We know that m is equal to minus l to plus l including 0. So here for l value 0, so m value will be also 0. Number of orbital, it is 1 orbital, because s subcell always have the 1 orbital with the 0 magnetic quantum number value. Now in third part of this question, n value is 5 and l value is 1. N value 5 means 5th cell, means partial quantum number 5 means 5th cell. L value 1 means it is P subcell. So P subcell of 5th cell means we may write this one, subcell name is 5P. And you know that possible value of magnetic quantum number means possible value of orbital. Here we may write orbital means M value minus L to plus L including 0. So here L value is what is given? 1. And m value we want to find, so it is minus 1, 0, plus 1. So if we count the total number of orbital, therefore it is 1, 2, 3. So total number of orbital will be 3. Similarly, in the case of fourth option, n value 4, l value is equal to 3. So n value 4 here means fourth cell, means fourth main energy level. L value 3 means it giving with respect to the which subcell? F subcell. So if we want to give the name of subcell, then it will be 4F. Now number of possible M values. So here L value 3, and you know one, and we know that M means magnetic quantum number value depend upon value of L, means value of azimuthal quantum number, that is L value. So it is start from minus L to plus L including 0. So here L value 3, therefore M value minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. So total if we count, then it comes 7. So total 7 orbital present in 4th cell with respect to F subcell. Now students, next question is, what is wrong with each of the following quantum numbers designation and or subcell name? So here we have to see the error with respect to the quantum number subcell. So here in the first case, it is given that n value 1, always n value may be find 1, 2, 3, 4, but here given l value 1. For n value 1, l value already know that l value is 0 to n minus 1. So if we find from value of l from this formula for given value of n, so 0 to n minus 1, so 0 to n minus 1 means 0 to 1 minus 1, that is 0 to 0 means 0. So l value should be 0, but it is given 1, it means it is wrong. It is wrong. Here it should be 0. Now, M value for L value 0, M value 0, it is correct. But here M value 0 means it is S subcell, first cell, so it should be 1S. But here name is given 1P, it is wrong. It should be 1S. Likewise, in second example, here cell number means principal quantum number value 4 is given. So, and L value is 3. So far, n is equal to 4, L value is 0 to n minus 1. So 0 to n value is given 4. So 4 minus 1 means 0 to 3. So L value may be 0, may be 1, may be 2, may be 3. So here 3 is given, so it is right. And value of, here value of plus 1. So here, in this case, value of m is plus 1. It is also right. Value of m may be plus 1. But here in the name, with respect to name, it is given 4D. Here L value is 3. It means it is F subcell. So it should be 4F. But it is given 4D. It should be 4F. Likewise, in question third point, means C option. What are given? C option, n value 3 is given, right? L value 1. So far, n is equal to 3, L value. For n is equal to 3, L value. 0 to n minus 1 means 0 to 3 minus 1 means 0 to 2. Means the L value may be 0, 1, 2. So it is right. And here for with respect to the 1, with respect to here, L value 1. So we have to write M value. So M value will be minus 1, 0 plus 1. But here given, minus 2, it is wrong. And here, third cell, so and S, here 1 means P subcell, so 3P it is right. So likewise, we may solve this problem. Here you can see the solution for third one. A subcell with L value 1 can have the M value minus 1, but it is given minus 2, it is wrong. Here it should be minus 1. And here since third cell, 1 means P subcell, so 3P it is right. Similarly, the case of second, fourth cell, L value may be 0, may be 1, may be 2, may be 3, so it is right. And here L value plus 1 for 3, L is equal to 3. So L M value minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0 plus 1, plus 2, plus 3. So it is also right. But here L is equal to 3 means F subcell. So it should be 4F here, 4D. It is wrong. It here should be 4F. In the B option, it should be 4F. So here it is given. It is right. In first one, we already described here. N value is 1, L value is 0. It is wrong, it should be 0. Here it is given, L value should be 0. And for that one, name of that one will be 1. Here it is given 0, so it will be 1s. It is given 1p, it is wrong, so 1s should be here. Only subcell is 1s, not 1p. In this way, we solve this problem. Now, next question is, designate each subcell with n is equal to 4 and principal quantum number value. In this question, principal quantum number value 4 means fourth cell is given, and we have to find out subcell. Each subcell means S, P, D, F, whatever subcell present in fourth cell, we have to designate. So here cell number 4 given. So fourth cell can have the L value. So n is equal to 4 is given in the question. So L may be, L value 0 to n minus 1. So L may be 0 to 4, 0 to 4 minus 1 means 0 to 3. 0 to 3. So L value may be 0, 1, 2 and 3. So this will be the L value, may be 0, 1, 2, 3. Name of subcell, for the 0 subcell, here L value 0 means S subcell. Since it belongs to the 4th cell, therefore 4S. Similarly, L value is 1 means P subcell belong to the 4 cell, therefore it is 4P. Next is L value is 2 means D subcell. D subcell belong to the cell number 4, so it will be 4D. Next is L value is 3 means F subcell. This F subcell belong to 4th cell, there it will be 4F. Now next question. On the basis of Pauli's exclusion principle, show that maximum number of electron in the EM cell, M means KL, M means third cell, N value is here given third. We in third cell we have to find out, we have to show that maximum number of electron. Maximum number of electron in any subcell, we already know, we indicated the formula 2N square. So directly we may solve this one. N value is 3, there are 2n square, so 2 into 3 square, 2 into square of 3, so it will be 2 into 9, means 18 electrons should be in third cell, according to the rule. So here solution is given, n value, third given in the question, L value, n value is 3, so L value 0 to n minus 1, so it will be 0 to 2. So, which may be 0, L value may be 0, 1, 2, these are 0, 1, 2. M value, you already know, M value always depend upon the value of L. So, M is equal to minus L2 plus L including 0. So, here we may write for M is equal to 0, L is equal to 0, M value is 0. For L is equal to 1, M value minus 1, 0 plus 1. For L is equal to 2, magnetic quantum number value, value minus 2, minus 1, 0, plus 1, plus 2. And here, spin quantum number, you already know, each orbital can hold the 2 electron. Therefore, here in S, M means S orbital, 2 electron, one will have the plus half value, next will have the minus half, therefore plus minus half. Here, minus 1 means this orbital will have 2 electron, value will be, spin value will be minus half, plus half, 0, value for magnetic quantum number 0 will also have the 2 electron, means plus half minus half, this will also have the 2 electron, plus half minus half. So here total number of electron 6, and here total number of electron 2. In the case of L value 2, M value here we described as here spin quantum number, each orbital have the 2 electron, therefore with respect to this orbital 2 electron plus minus half, for this one also 2 electron plus minus half, for this one also 2 electron plus minus half, for this one also 2 electron plus minus half, and for this one also 2 electron plus minus half. So here 2 electron to 4, 6, 8, 10, so total electron 10. So if we find out the aggregate means complete total grand total number of electron in third cell, M cell means third cell, it will be 2 plus 6 plus 10, that is 18. Thank you, students.